Welcome to today's flip class. Children, have you ever wondered why ice floats on water, though it is a solid form of water? Why water is a liquid at room temperature? Or what is the force that holds the two strands in a DNA? To get answers to all these questions, let's see what is a hydrogen bond. Define a bond. A bond is a force of attraction which holds constituents together. Now this force could be the intermolecular forces of attraction which holds molecules together, or the force that holds atoms together in a molecule. Now the force that holds the atoms together to form a molecule, you know that there are two types of forces. One is called the ionic bond and the other one is the covalent bond. And the other force that we already discussed is the force of attraction which holds molecules together, which we call as the intermolecular forces of attraction. Let's say the force which holds H2S molecules together is the intermolecular force of attraction. Now let's see how is a hydrogen bond different than an ionic or a covalent bond, or how is it different than the intermolecular force of attraction which is holding the two molecules together, the most common type being the van der Waals force of attraction or the dispersion forces as we say. To understand this, let's see exactly what is a hydrogen bond. We'll take a very simple example now. Let's take hydrogen molecule. Now hydrogen molecule, as you already know, is formed by a covalent bond which is formed by sharing of a pair of electrons between two hydrogen atoms. Now because this is a covalent molecule, the two electrons are shared equally by the two atoms together. Now if I take another example, let's say HF. Now here there is a difference. Though this is also a covalently bonded molecule, fluorine, as you all know, is the most electronegative atom. So this pair of electrons between the two HF is not shared equally, rather it is pulled a little more tightly, closely towards fluorine atom, something like this, because of which this fluorine will develop a small partial negative charge. Consequently, the hydrogen will develop a small partial positive charge. Now the difference that you see in these two molecules is, there is no polarity developed here, whereas here there is a polarity developed. Now what will happen if we have many molecules of HF? We'll see the same phenomena here as well. So the pair of electrons will be pulled a little more towards the fluorine atoms. So this will give it a partial negative charge and this hydrogen a partial positive charge. Same would be the case here, this with a negative charge and this with a partial positive charge. Now because of the polarity that is developed here, this hydrogen of one molecule will attract the fluorine of the neighboring molecule because of opposite charges that are there. So a new type of interaction has developed here, and this interaction is a strong force. Similarly, we have this fluorine being attracted by this hydrogen of the neighboring HF molecule. see two types of forces. One here, this is a covalent bond which is holding the atoms together in the HF molecule. And this, the intermolecular force of attraction which is holding the HF molecules together. Now to be very specific, what type of intermolecular force of attraction is this? This is called as your hydrogen bond. Why do we call this as a hydrogen bond? Because you have the hydrogen forming a link between two molecules. Therefore, it is also called as the hydrogen bridge. Now let's apply this concept to another molecule. Let's see what happens in case of hydrogen. Now these hydrogen molecules will be also linked to one another by means of some force of attraction, which we call as the intermolecular forces of attraction. Now if I compare the two forces here, the intermolecular force of attraction in HF and in H2, you must be aware that this definitely is a stronger force of attraction than the force of attraction which is holding H2 molecules together. Because here there is no polarity, whereas here this attraction has resulted because of polarity in the molecule. So this is going to be called as only van der Waals force of attraction or the dispersion forces, which is a weak force of attraction, whereas this is a hydrogen bond. A hydrogen bond is stronger than dispersion forces, but at the same time it is weaker than a covalent bond. In terms of bond length, it is a little longer than the covalent bond. So children, a hydrogen bond is a force of attraction which results when a hydrogen atom is bonded to an electronegative atom. Now which electronegative atom do we consider? We know the most electronegative atoms that we have are fluorine, oxygen and nitrogen in that order. So whenever hydrogen is bonded either to fluorine, oxygen or nitrogen, a force of attraction results because of the polarity that is developed. This force of attraction that is generated is called as the hydrogen bond. Let's take some examples of hydrogen bonding. Let's take water. H2O has an oxygen bonded to two hydrogen atoms by means of two covalent bonds. Now here again you have an electronegative atom, oxygen. Now this oxygen is going to pull the pair of electrons which is shared between oxygen and hydrogen a little more towards oxygen. So this is going to give it a partial negative charge. Same is the case happening in this covalent bond. So this will give it a partial negative charge. Consequently, the two hydrogens will have partial positive charges. So if I have another water molecule, this oxygen with a partial negative charge, the hydrogen with partial positive charges. Now because of the polarity of the molecule, what will happen? A new type of interaction is going to be developed. That is, this hydrogen of the other water molecule is going to be linked to this oxygen. And what is this type of a bond called as? A hydrogen bond. Let's take the example of ammonia. Again, nitrogen is an electronegative atom. So this covalent bond will develop charges. So nitrogen will pull the electrons towards itself, giving it partial negative charges, and hydrogens will get partial positive charges. Now this will result in holding the ammonia molecules to one another by means of a strong force of attraction. Called as the hydrogen bond. You've seen three examples of hydrogen bonding. One is HF, the other case is the force holding water molecules together, and the force which is responsible for holding ammonia molecules together. So this force is definitely stronger than the dispersion forces. Therefore, these molecules are a little closer than the other molecules. That explains precisely as to why water is a liquid at room temperature. Because H2O molecules are held a little more tightly, they are brought a little closer, therefore it exists as a liquid at room temperature. That also explains as to why HF is a liquid, whereas all the other hydrogen halides are gases. HCl, HBr, HI, these are gases. It's only HF which exists in the form of a liquid. The reason being, again, because HF molecules are held together by means of a strong force of attraction, that is a hydrogen bond, which is not present in case of HCl, HBr and HI. They are held together by weaker forces of attraction. Let's study the consequences or effects of a hydrogen bond. It is seen that compounds which contain hydrogen bonding have higher melting and boiling points. That precisely explains as to why only water, when you consider the hydrides of group 16, exists in the liquid state. Whereas the other hydrides of group 16, they are gases at room temperature, because water molecules are held together by a stronger force of attraction, that is a hydrogen bond. We began this class today by saying that we will be able to find out the answers as to why ice floats on water. Let's go for the answer. Let's study the structure of ice. Now, ice is made up of water molecules which are held together by some force of attraction. Let's see the force of attraction. In case of ice, you have the water molecules which are held together by means of hydrogen bonding. The structure that is seen in case of ice is that four water molecules come closer to each other to form a cage-like structure. Now, because of the cage-like structure of ice, there is a vacant space or a void which is generated. Now, because of this void, there is an increase in the volume, and we all know that density is inversely proportional to volume. Therefore, when water freezes to form ice, there is an increase in the volume because of this cage-like structure. And because of the increase in volume, there is a decrease in the density, which makes ice float on water, though it is a solid form of water. The other applications or consequences of hydrogen bonding are, it is seen that substances with hydrogen bonding are more viscous. That again explains because they are held closer tightly by a stronger force of attraction, which we call as the hydrogen bond. So their viscosity is higher. Also, when we compare or study the structure of proteins, the proteins is a biomolecule in which there are many amino acids which are linked together by means of a peptide linkage. When we study the structure of a protein, There are many forces which holds together the structure of a food protein, and one very important force which makes up the structure of the protein is a hydrogen bond. Also, the famous structure of DNA. We know that DNA is a double-stranded molecule. Ever wondered as to what holds the two strands together? Yes, the two strands are held together by means of hydrogen bond between the nitrogenous bases. The adenine of one strand is held together by a hydrogen bond to the thymine of the other strand. Similarly, you have guanine bonded to cytosine, again by means of hydrogen bond. So it is the hydrogen bond which holds the two strands together in a DNA. Hydrogen bonding also explains the reason for solubility of some substances in water. For example, alcohol is soluble in water because alcohol forms hydrogen bond with water molecules. So children, we've seen many applications of hydrogen bonding. I hope the concept of a hydrogen bond is clear to you all. Thank you very much.